Launch vehicle, the foundational first step of any space mission. A launch vehicle, or rocket, is a launch system whose purpose is to provide the immense thrust needed to overcome Earth's gravity and deliver a payload, such as a satellite, probe, or crew capsule, into space. They are typically multi-stage vehicles that shed empty stages as they ascend. While most are expendable and used only once, a new generation of reusable rockets has revolutionized access to space. Earth orbiting satellite. This is the most common type of spacecraft. A satellite is an uncrewed object placed in orbit around the Earth to perform a specific job. This category includes communication satellites that relay internet and television signals, weather satellites that monitor cloud patterns, navigation satellites for GPS systems, and reconnaissance or spy satellites that provide intelligence. Their common feature is that their mission is focused on our own planet. CubeSat. This is not a mission type, but a class of spacecraft defined by its small, standardized form factor. A CubeSat is built in units of a 10-centimeter cube. This standardization has democratized access to space, allowing universities and small companies to build and launch their own satellites cheaply, often as secondary payloads on larger rockets. While most are used for Earth observation or technology demonstrations, some have even been sent on interplanetary missions, proving that capable science can come in very small packages. Space telescope. A space telescope is a highly specialized satellite whose mission is to look outward, away from Earth. By being placed above the blurring effects of the atmosphere, telescopes like Hubble and the James Webb Space Telescope can capture breathtakingly clear and deep images of distant stars, galaxies, and nebulae. They are humanity's eyes in the cosmos, providing the foundational data for nearly all of modern astronomy. Space capsule. This is the classic vehicle for human spaceflight. A space capsule is a small, typically cone-shaped or spherical craft with a blunt protected bottom that serves as a heat shield for the fiery re-entry into Earth's atmosphere. Its job is to act as a pressurized cabin to transport humans to and from space. From the Vostok and Mercury capsules to Apollo, Soyuz, and the modern SpaceX Crew Dragon, their simple, stable design is the most proven way to safely bring astronauts home. Spaceplane. A spaceplane is a reusable spacecraft that has wings, allowing it to land on a runway like a conventional airplane. The most famous example is the American Space Shuttle, which launched vertically like a rocket, but landed horizontally like a glider. A spaceplane combines the features of a rocket and an aircraft, designed to be a versatile space truck for carrying large crews and heavy cargo to and from low Earth orbit. Space station. A space station is not a transport vehicle, but a destination. It is a large, crewed structure placed in a long-term orbit that serves as an outpost, habitat, and laboratory in space. From the early Salyut stations and Mir to the massive International Space Station and China's Tiangong, these are humanity's homes in the cosmos, designed for the long-duration study of how microgravity affects science and the human body. Space tug. A space tug is an in-space taxi for cargo. It is a simple, propulsive spacecraft that operates only in orbit, designed to move other objects from one orbit to another. For example, a tug could grapple a newly launched satellite in a low parking orbit and efficiently ferry it to its final, much higher geostationary orbit. Future tugs may be used to service satellites or move payloads between Earth orbit and the Moon. Flyby probe. This is the simplest type of interplanetary explorer. A flyby probe is designed for a cosmic drive-by, a one-time encounter with a celestial body. It does not stop or orbit, but uses its high speed to travel to distant worlds, gathering as much data and as many images as possible during its brief, high-speed pass. The Voyager and New Horizons missions are prime examples, trading long-term study for the ability to visit multiple or very distant targets. Orbiter. An orbiter is a more advanced robotic probe that, upon reaching its destination, fires its engines to slow down and enter into a long-term orbit around another planet or moon. This allows for a far more detailed and sustained scientific mission than a flyby. Orbiters are the workhorses of planetary exploration, responsible for mapping surfaces, studying atmospheres, and acting as communication relays for landers. Missions like Cassini at Saturn and the Mars Reconnaissance Orbiter are classic examples. Lander. A lander is a spacecraft designed to travel to a celestial body and make a soft, controlled landing on its surface. Its mission is to be a stationary science platform, studying its immediate surroundings in great detail. Landers use whatever entry, descent, and landing system fits the target body, ranging from heat shields and parachutes used at Mars and Venus to purely retro rockets used on the Moon, or even no atmosphere-dependent hardware at all for small bodies. The Viking and InSight missions to Mars are prime examples of landers that studied Martian geology and weather from a single location. Rover. A rover is a lander that can move. It is a robotic wheeled vehicle designed to be a mobile field geologist on the surface of another world. This mobility allows it to explore a wide variety of terrains, analyze different rocks and soils, and travel to scientifically interesting features far from its initial landing site. The Soviet Lunokhods on the Moon and NASA's iconic Mars rovers, like Spirit, Opportunity, and Perseverance, have fundamentally changed our ability to explore other planets. Hopper. A hopper is a unique type of mobile lander that explores by jumping instead of rolling. Using either rockets or powerful springs, a hopper can launch itself from one point on the surface and land at another, kilometers away. This method is ideal for exploring low-gravity, rugged bodies like asteroids or small moons, where wheels would be impractical and a single landing site would be too limiting. Penetrator probe. A highly specialized type of hard lander designed to be a cosmic javelin. A penetrator is not meant to land softly, but to impact a celestial body like an asteroid or a moon at high speed. It is built to survive the crash and embed itself deep beneath the surface, allowing its instruments to analyze the subsurface composition and structure, a region that regular landers cannot reach. Atmospheric probe. This is a highly specialized one-way spacecraft designed for a suicidal plunge into the atmosphere of a gas giant or a planet with a thick atmosphere. It has no landing system. Its sole purpose is to transmit data on the atmosphere's temperature, pressure, and chemical composition for as long as it can survive the crushing forces of its descent. The Galileo probe's descent into Jupiter is the most famous example. Aerobot. An aerobot is a robotic weather balloon designed to operate in the atmosphere of another planet. Unlike an atmospheric probe that takes a one-way plunge, a balloon can float for days or weeks, traveling with the winds and making long-duration measurements of atmospheric conditions over a wide geographical area. The most famous examples are the two balloons the Soviet Vega program successfully deployed into the clouds of Venus in 1985. Impactor. An impactor is a spacecraft that is deliberately crashed into a celestial body. This is done for one of two reasons: either to analyze the composition of the resulting debris plume, as was done by the Deep Impact mission at Comet Tempel 1, or to attempt to physically alter the target's trajectory, which was the goal of the DART mission's planetary defense test. Solar sail. This is a spacecraft that sails on sunlight. A solar sail is a large, thin, reflective membrane that is propelled not by rocket fuel, but by the continuous, gentle pressure of photons from the sun. While the thrust is tiny, it is continuous and propellant-free, though it decreases with distance from the sun. This makes solar sails ideal for long-duration, low-thrust missions, such as hovering over the sun's poles or slowly spiraling out of the solar system. Japan's Icaros was the first successful demonstration of this technology. Sample return. This is the most complex type of robotic mission ever attempted. A sample return spacecraft must acquire material from a target and deliver it safely to Earth, which can involve orbiting and landing with an ascent stage on some missions, or simpler approaches like touch-and-go collection or flyby capture, depending on the destination. Japan's Hayabusa 2 and NASA's OSIRIS-REx are modern triumphs of this incredibly demanding mission type. Thanks for watching. What spacecraft type do you think we'll need next, but haven't built yet? Let me know what you think in the comments. Also, please remember to like and subscribe if you enjoyed this video.